Tiki Torch Nights was started mainly to highlight a historical spot in Atlanta, being a vintage tiki bar. So the idea was born out of, let's gather people together that appreciate, you know, Trader Vic's and tiki culture and want to have a good time. It's never boring. It's, you know, we always have constant flow of entertainment.
My friend Christopher Dale and I formed Tongo Hiti because I purchased an ukulele, not knowing how to play it. So we went to our secret lair and we woodshed it until our fingers were numb and we learned all these great songs, a lot of the ukulele music with an awful lot of humor mixed in.
That's kind of the approach that we take with tongue-in-cheek or sense of humor.
High concept.
Yeah. We try to be high concept, whether it comes across that way or
maybe
not.
Maybe low-brow, but high concept.
Yeah, exactly. Low-brow, high concept. I like that.
I don't really like using the term burlesque revival because I think burlesque has been around and will always be around in whatever form. It's entertainment. It's showbiz.
I think I can speak for everyone in the group that they like dancing with live bands because it just, it's energizing and there is that
showbiz quality of whatever could happen, could happen.
We feed off of the energy off of the dancers who are feeding off of the energy from the audience. So it's this kind of feeding chain that goes on. And the view as well, the view is pretty nice as well.
Finding a balance between having fun with the kitschy pop culture aspects of this stuff, but also having respect for the island societies that spawned this iconography can be tricky. Each of the major Polynesian cultures have their own tiki figures made out of different materials and for different purposes. In some cultures, they're good luck charms. In some cultures, they're depictions of ancestors. A lot of people just show up at these things because they want to have a Mai Tai, but there is another group of people that are genuinely interested in tribal art, and I think it's cool because it brings those people together. And as long as people are learning from each other, it's a good thing.
I think combining it all is the right balance. And put a little whack-a-daisy into it. It works perfect. Raffles are held throughout the night, giving away prizes and so forth. We also found a local hula troupe by the name of Hula Halau Kapili Aloha. We were amazed that there was a group right here in Atlanta.
We perform in two segments. We do the Hawaii segment, which is the modern day hula. We also do the Tahitian as well. The girls, when they're dancing, they portray the song. The hands tell the story. In Tahitian, the hips tell the story.
The songs we play now has been around for many, many years. I've been playing music all my life. Actually started playing the Hawaiian music when we come to Georgia. I guess being away from Hawaii has just brought me closer, really.
We want to present Hawaii to you if you can't go to Hawaii. The fun is here, the love is here, and it makes it just such a joy to perform.
I love being around the family that it brings. It's your one chance to see all those people again and to celebrate all over again each and every month. We have a blast.